What if I tell you that there's a possibility जो भी futuristic चीजें हम movies में देखते हैं वो एक reality बन सकता है. From superheroes to sci-fi to augmented reality, सब कुछ एक reality बन सकता है. Like everything sounds exciting, right? We as humans can do some pretty impressive things. Like we can innovate using our brains. We can even train to hold our breath. And our bodies can fight many diseases. Just like that, a paralyzed man sends tweet using his mind after microchip was installed in his brain. He became the first person to tweet a message to the world using only direct thought. Imagine what life will be like with all the superpowers and super intelligence. Today we will talk about brain-computer interface, human augmentation and artificial intelligence. But before that, we need to talk about that. Is it making us superhumans or making our future super weird?
Okay, then tell me. Please tell me.
But first, we need to answer this simple question. Do we really need these technological advancements to enhance our way of living? Knowingly or unknowingly, we have been using AI like literally in our everyday lives. From Google search or what content Instagram chooses to show you on your consumption patterns, to checking grammar online and the phone cameras, trying to make us look beautiful than we already are with its computational photography and so on. The smartphones and the smart home devices have become part of our everyday lives because smartphones ne to hamari life kaafi easy bana di hai. The devices that we hold or wear are considered the form of enhancement. So yes, we definitely need these technological advancements to enhance our abilities to make us do things that were once an imagination, but it's now becoming a reality. From self-driving cars to flying cars to dishwashing robots, all have been possible through AI. But now we want to take the idea of AI to not only enhance lives, but to take human intelligence to the next level. And the next level is the brain-computer interface, जो हमारी जिंदगी और जज्बात दोनों बदल देंगे. Imagine we don't have to physically write or speak, but through our thoughts we can prepare our presentation, we can even switch on the TV, can operate the remote, we can switch to different channels. जिस रिमोट के लिए इतनी लड़ाइयाँ होती थी, we don't even have to touch that remote. इतने में ही excited हो गए कि channel change कर सकते हो. थोड़ा बड़ा सोचो यार. By understanding the power of the human brain, the brain-computer interface will help us manipulate machinery or computers with nothing but our thoughts. And it is going to be an important breakthrough for disabled people. And it will also help us move closer to making science fiction into reality. One of the recent example of this is Elon Musk's Neuralink for mental augmentation to improve human intelligence, which could now be a possibility by 2022. But aren't we already intelligent to carry out our day-to-day activities? Yes, we are. But Neuralink aims to develop a brain-machine interface jo ki hume superpowers dega to interact with computers on a neural level. He said it's kind of a fit band that fits in your skull with tiny wires. Iska matlab hai, ek chipset hamare brain ke andar surgically insert kiya jayega aur usme kafi sare insulated wires connected honge from electrodes jo ki use kiye jayenge. और ये सब होने के बाद हम अपने स्मार्टफोन्स और कंप्यूटर्स बिना टच करे ऑपरेट कर पाएंगे. वेलकम टू द एरा ऑफ स्मार्ट ह्यूमंस. स्मार्ट तो हम हमेशा से ही थे, पर अब ये स्मार्ट का एक टैग हमारे पीछे लग जाएगा. जस्ट लाइक स्मार्टफोन्स, वी विल बी कॉल्ड एज स्मार्ट ह्यूमंस. द टेक्नोलॉजी विल बी यूज्ड फ्रॉम एजुकेशन टू प्रोस्थेटिक्स टू गेमिंग एंड टू स्मार्ट होम कंट्रोल्स. इट विल ऑल्सो हेल्प पैरालिसिस पेशेंट टू कंट्रोल कंप्यूटर्स और कीबोर्ड थ्रू द इंफॉर्मेशन रीड आउट फ्रॉम द ब्रेन. अनदर कंपनी दैट वॉज ऑल्सो वर्किंग ऑन द ब्रेन कंप्यूटर इंटरफेस वॉज फेसबुक मेटा टू अलाउ इंडिविजुअल्स टू स्पीक यूजिंग नथिंग बट देयर थॉट्स. The tech was supposed to read our thoughts and minds using our neurons and translate them into words. But the company has stopped the research as some scientists said that it was never possible. Meta. Meta has also unveiled its mind-reading wrist device and an augmented reality keyboard which will replace the mouse and the physical keyboard. And the wrist device can read neurological signals from the user's brain down to the wrist. बेसिकली उनका फोकस एक डिफरेंट न्यूरल अप्रोच पर है विच कैन बी क्रिएटेड मच सूनर एंड बी टेकन टू द मार्केट्स. Another company that is working on the brain-computer interface is the NextMind. They have a headset that measures activity using the sensors in the back of your head. The headset will translate the user's decision of where to focus their eyes into digital commands. It's like controlling any device by focusing our thoughts on them. By wearing the NextMind headset, we can even turn on the TV screens just by staring at it. और अपनी आंखों को फोकस करके वी कैन इवन चेंज द चैनल्स। NextMind's technology isn't available to consumers, but the company is selling a developer kit in the hope that other companies can create new applications. Another company that focused on the brain-computer interface is this. The company has focused on a headband that will send signals to your scalp. The headgear will let people, those who are wearing, focus on things, operate them, and make them function. This will also help people to focus their minds on one thing and help them not to zone out while working. MindX is another company that combines neurotechnology, augmented reality, and artificial intelligence to create look and think interface. Through their smart glasses, a link between human brains and technology is created, which will let us access information with our thoughts. So without a touch or a tap, we will be able to control the interface. These brain-computer interface glasses will open up a world of opportunities for visual search. But do you think that with the brain-computer interface, the future is going to get super weird? Although these technologies are seen as a huge breakthrough, it is still a potential threat to our future. As these big tech companies could now know what we are thinking and even have the potential to interfere with our mental privacy. It's similar to the privacy issues that we face with our smartphones. The time is almost here when we wouldn't know where our self ends and the machine begins. Yes, it's weird, but with time and everything, just like the smart devices that have become the part of our everyday life, this too will become a new normal.